Grace and peace to you, sisters and brothers. Amy Wilson Feltz here, coming to you from the parsonage of St. Paul's United Methodist Church in El Paso. Thank you for joining me for coffee this morning. Once again, this is something to which I look forward every week so that we can connect and grow with one another. I wanted to talk to you this morning about our daughter, Natalie. I think I have mentioned this before. Natalie is 5 and she is an extrovert. It's really easy to see that even at her young age. She clearly derives energy from being around other people. So that being said, you can imagine during this time when we have severely decreased the amount of interaction that we have with people outside of our immediate family, she has struggled a little bit. And anytime she is able to make connections with people outside of our family, she has a really great day. So the other day she was feeling sad. She was missing her friends, and she was able to communicate that to me, which was wonderful. And she offered an idea. She said, "Mom, what about writing notes to people?" So for her at 5, that means taking a crayon and drawing a picture and then asking me how to spell names. So we worked on that for a little bit. She did most of the work. And then she asked me, how are we going to deliver these notes? So I thought about it and I picked up some envelopes and I put her notes inside them and I addressed them to her friends and she put the stamps on them. And then we decided to walk to our neighborhood mailbox so that she would have the experience of opening the chute and putting the letters in. And it was a great time. It gave us a chance to walk outside and be together and talk, but it also gave her the opportunity to really feel like she was connecting with people, even though she didn't have that immediate satisfaction of interacting face to face. So it was a teaching moment for her, and it was a sweet moment for me as well. And I've really been thinking about that over the last few days. I've been thinking about the letters that we have in our New Testament. They were written by many different people, but several of them were written by the Apostle Paul. And so many of them began with greetings, such as grace and peace to you, sisters and brothers, the peace of the Lord be with you, the peace of God the Father Almighty be with you. I've been thinking about those letters and how many of them had different purposes. Some of them were for instruction, some of them were for encouragement, some of them were to help mediate a conflict, but so many of them began with greetings of grace and of peace and of connection. And it reminds me that the writers of the letters were seeking that connection and offering that connection and writing because they cared about the people who would receive those letters, just as Natalie was writing to people that she cared about as well. So I have begun my own letter writing campaign. It's going to take me a while. My first list consists of members of the church. I'm only writing 2 letters a day, so it's going to take a while. So if you haven't received one yet, don't worry. It's coming. And if you are not on our membership list and you would like to receive a note from me, you're welcome to send me an email with your address, and I would be happy to send you one. And I've just been thinking about ways that we can connect using these tried and true classic methods. Technology and the way that it has advanced is wonderful. It's allowing us to connect in a certain way right now, and I'm really grateful for that. But our low-tech ways, such as using the United States Postal Service to send a message, work too. And in some ways, they are more intentional and more deliberate, and I think the recipient can feel that. It took a little more effort to write a note than it did to pick up the phone and call or send a text. Those are great ways to connect too, and we use those methods as well, but there was something really special about writing those notes with Natalie, and I'm also finding that I feel that I'm connecting with the people to whom I'm writing every day, and they haven't even received their notes yet, so there's no reciprocation yet, if there will be any at all, but I still already feel connected. So those are some things that we can do to reach out and connect with people, especially when we're feeling isolated, and I'm proud that Natalie was already able to see that at 5, and I hope that we can learn from her example. And if you have any ideas, if you've been connecting in some lower tech ways with people and you'd like to share those, again, please send me an email and I will be glad to read those and also share them with other people. And in the meantime, know that I do send you greetings of grace and of peace and of encouragement, and I hope that you're able to receive those and also share those with other people as we continue to stay connected during this time. I look forward to being with you again here next week. Have a great, great week until then. Grace and peace.